I'm Jamie Hooper with Remax Crest and jamiehooper.com, and it's January, and it's time to do our annual talk about how your property taxes are calculated and how they figure out what your portion of the dollar amount is that you owe. So every January, we like to do a little review on your property taxes and just how the government calculates how much you owe, how they figure out your assessed value, is it the same as your market value, and then how much they determine that you need to pay them. So first of all, I like to do a little scenario to tell you how market value and assessed value differ. So in July last year, the assessments that you just received in January were done last July. And they calculate what the value of your property was at that time. And then they release them to you 6 months later. So first of all, by the time you get this information, it's already 6 months old. If the market has declined in the 6 months, your assessed value might be a little too high. And if the market's gone up, it might be a little too low. So let's just take the scenario here that we have three houses all built beside each other by the same builder back in 1978. And they're all in the exact same size lot, and he used the same footprint for each house. He just painted one red, one green, and one blue at the time. Now, the city will have these assessments all at pretty much $1 million, and they'd probably all be at pretty much near or close to lot value, where the land is worth most of the value and the building is worth very little. So their assessed values, let's say they're all on 50 by 120 lots, they're all assessed at $1 million each, but the actual market value of these homes would be completely different. For the first home, it was bought by a young couple a few years back. And the husband is a real handyman, and he's done a lot of work around the house. The wife is a beautiful gardener. They've got beautifully landscaped gardens, and they've redone this home from top to bottom and put a couple $100,000 into it. The second home is owned by the original owners. They're still in there, and their house is immaculate. It is very clean, but it is completely dated. It's never had any updating done to this home. And the third house has been rented for a good portion of the 40 years, and they've got foot-high grass in the backyard. It's never had any renovations, and it has zero street appeal when you pull up to it. So let's talk about the market values. Even though they're all assessed at $1 million, the first one, because of all the renovations done to it, is probably going to be worth closer to $1.2 million, even though it's assessed at $1 million. The second one, it would probably be reasonably accurate to assume that this house is probably going to be worth around the market value. To get it to be worth as much as the other one, they would have to spend a bunch of money on investments to be worth the market value of the one that the young couple moved into. And the third one is in pretty rough shape. The only one that's probably going to buy that home is someone who's looking to knock it down and build a new property. So that gives you a little insight into how the government determines what the assessed value of your home is. There's also, that's the first part of it. The second thing that comes up that we get a lot of questions about is, or we hear people say is, wow, the government keeps, as my house goes up in value, the government keeps raising my taxes. Well, that's not how it comes across. When you're paying out more dollars in general, that means the city needs more money to run the city. It's not because the value of your home went up. If you notice, when the value of your home goes down, your taxes don't go down either. Once they get the hooks in, they're never going to let them back. But it was, when you're paying more in tax dollars, the actual check that you cut, not your assessed value, is what's going up, because the city needs more money to operate. So if you have any questions or concerns or any opinions, if you think I'm crazy or full of BS, say that below in the comments too. If you like what we've done, please click subscribe or hit like, and we look forward to talking to you soon with another email. With another video, I should say. I'm Jamie Hooper with Remax Crest and jamiehooper.com, and we look forward to speaking with you again soon.